Willkommen zurück zu The Stanley Parable Ultra Deluxe. Wir hatten wieder mal eine etwas längere Ladezeit, was bedeutet, denke ich mal, dass wir wieder alles zu Null zurückgesetzt haben, oder Null in Anführungszeichen. Okay, ich muss zugeben, langsam gehen mir die Ideen aus, was man hier noch verfolgen kann. Wir haben immer noch The Broom Closet. Ich erinnere mich auch noch daran, dass das durchaus lustig war. Ich kann euch nur überhaupt nicht mehr sagen, was man dafür alles tun müsste. Ich frage mich, hat die Uhrzeit hier irgendwas zu sagen? Ich denke, es soll einfach nur nebenbei ticken, um halt authentisch zu wirken. Ich habe immer das Gefühl, man soll hier irgendwas vielleicht in dem Raum noch machen, denn immer wenn eine Tür sich schließt, hat man, ich sag mal, so eine gewisse Entscheidung getroffen. Aber hier ist halt leider nicht viel, mit dem man sonst interagieren darf. Wir hatten am Anfang ja auch schon versucht, einfach nur das mit warten. Weißt du was? Ich werde einfach mal voran skippen. Falls hier was passieren sollte. Ich will einfach mal noch mal ein bisschen länger hier stehen bleiben. Also ich habe jetzt für 6 Minuten ungefähr gewartet. Und es passiert halt scheinbar nichts. Okay.
Someone was following Stanley. He was sure of it. If he checked over his shoulder now, he would surely catch them. It was only a matter of time.
Okay. That's new. Hier, da gehen wir logischerweise noch nicht lang.
When Stanley came to a set of 2 open doors, he entered the door on his left.
Okay.
This was not the correct way to the meeting room, and Stanley knew it perfectly well. Perhaps he wanted to stop by the employee lounge first, just to admire it. The lounge was grand, majestic, perhaps too majestic. Like a combination of a much smaller version and a much larger version of this exact room. It all made Stanley uncomfortable, and he started to bleed a little. But this made him smile. At last, proof that he was human.
Sure.
But eager to get back to business, Stanley took the first open door on his left.
Okay, und jetzt fangen wir mit der Sache mal.
And so he detoured through the maintenance section, walked straight ahead to the opposite door, and got back on track.
Schade, okay.
Yet there was not a single person here either. Feeling a wave of disbelief, Stanley decided to go up to his boss's office, hoping he might find an answer there.
Oh.
Stanley stepped into the broom closet, but there was nothing here, so he turned around and got back on track.
No. Nuh-uh.
There was nothing here. No choice to make, no path to follow. Just an empty broom closet. No reason to still be here. It was baffling that Stanley was still just sitting in the broom closet. He wasn't even doing anything. At least if there was something to interact with, he'd be justified in some way. As it is, he's literally just standing there doing sweet F.A. Are you really still in the broom closet? Standing around doing nothing? Why? Please offer me some explanation here. I'm genuinely confused. You do realize there's no choice or anything in here, right? If I'd said Stanley walked past the broom closet, at least you would have had a reason for exploring it to find out. But it didn't even occur to me, because literally, this closet is of absolutely no significance to the story whatsoever. I never would have thought to mention it. Maybe to you, this is somehow its own branching path. Maybe when you go talk about this with your friends, you'll say, "Oh, did you get the broom closet ending? The broom closet ending was my favorite." I hope your friends find this concerning. Stanley was fat and ugly and really, really stupid. He probably only got the job because of a family connection. That's how stupid he is. That or with drug money. Also, Stanley is addicted to drugs and hookers.
Hell yeah.
Well, I've come to a very definite conclusion about what's going on right now. You're dead. You got to this broom closet, explored it a bit, and were just about to leave because there's nothing here, when a physical malady of some sort shut down your central nervous system and you collapsed on the keyboard. Well, in a situation like this, the responsible thing is to alert someone nearby so as to ensure that your body is taken care of before it begins to decompose. Hello? Anyone who happens to be nearby? The person at this computer is dead. They have fallen prey to any number of your countless human physiological vulnerabilities. It's indicative of the long-term sustainability of your species. Please remove their corpse from the area and instruct another human to take their place, making sure they understand basic first-person video game mechanics and filling them in on the history of narrative tropes in video gaming, so that the irony and insightful commentary of this game is not lost on them. All right, when you've done that, just step out into the hallway.
No. Don't wanna. Ah, vielleicht ist das jetzt das Ende von der Hinsicht.
Ah, second player. It's good to have you on board. I guarantee you can't do any worse than the person who came before you.
Oh, doch.
You too? Unbelievable. I'm at the mercy of an entire species of invalids. Perhaps there's a monkey nearby you can hand the controls to. A fish? Fungus? Look, you can hammer out the details. I'm not particularly picky. I'll just be waiting for when you're ready to pick up the story again.
Aww. Okay.
Coming to a staircase, ja. Stanley walked upstairs to his boss's office.
Ja, nach unten ist nicht mehr viel. Absicht. No. Okay, down. Down. Alles klar. Die anderen Türen eigentlich irgendwie relevant? Oh, hier ist nur eine. Hey. I got the feeling money's for stealing, but not yours, of course. Say, that's a lovely purse. Und immer noch alles Klicky-Klacky-Geräusche. Okay. Ah.
The moment he entered his manager's office, Stanley froze in his tracks.
No, I didn't.
Not a living soul anywhere. Could he really be all alone? This was too much for Stanley to take. Too much for any man to take. He fell to his knees, bursting into half moans, half sobs, the guttural retching of life from a man denied any hope, any reason to keep going. Here on the floor, he lay prone, paralyzed by fear for nearly a full hour. But when at last he began to move about and survey the situation, he found a keypad behind the boss's desk. What could it mean? Was it a sign of hope for Stanley's future? Alas, it was not. For although this keypad guarded the terrible secret of Stanley's past, it had been assigned a 4-digit code so devious and so random that no man could ever hope to guess it. 2845. Statistically, nearly impossible to guess blindly, ever.
Ich weiß nicht, warum hier halt der Cursor aufploppt. Vermutlich, weil ich in der Nähe von dem Ding bin. Aber ehrlich, so weit sind wir auch nicht. So, ich will mal ganz bewusst testen, was passiert.
Stanley just sat around twiddling his thumbs. Trying to input anything on the device was useless, since he could never possibly know that the combination was 2845. But it turns out that the panel's emergency override kicked in, and the door just opened all by itself, and Stanley got the hell along with the story. Well, whoop-de-doo.
Ich gehe mich davon aus, dass ich die einfach wieder öffnen darf, um abzuhauen. Nee. Was passiert? Kann ich es jetzt nochmal eingeben? Oh, I can. Nur schwer zu sehen. Wie ist das eine 1? What? Ich hier oben draufklicke. Edit it! Reward me! Okay. So, hier ist, glaube ich, sonst so überhaupt nichts mehr. Außer eine lustige Ecke, der. Okay. Warum auch immer ich hier hinten hingehen kann. Ja. Schade. Okay.
Stanley walked straight ahead through the large door that read Mind Control Facility.
No.
Although this passageway had the word escape written on it, the truth was that at the end of this hall, Stanley would meet his violent death.
Cool.
The door behind him was not shut. Stanley still had every opportunity to turn around and get back on track.
Aber da kann ich nicht brutal umgebracht werden.
At this point, Stanley was making a conscious, concerted effort to walk forward and willingly confront his death.
Yeah, boy.
As the machine whirred into motion, and Stanley was inched closer and closer to his demise, he reflected that his life had been of no consequence whatsoever. Stanley can't see the bigger picture. He doesn't know the real story, trapped forever in his narrow vision of what this world is. Perhaps his death was of no great loss, like plucking the eyeballs from a blind man. And so he resigned and willingly accepted this violent end to his brief and shallow life. Farewell, Stanley.
Bye.
Farewell, Stanley, cried the narrator, as Stanley was led helplessly into the enormous metal jaws. In a single visceral instant, Stanley was obliterated, as the machine crushed every bone in his body, killing him instantly.
Nicht ganz, oder? Oh.
And yet it would be just a few minutes before Stanley would restart the game, back in his office, as alive as ever. What exactly did the narrator think he was going to accomplish? When every path you can walk has been created for you long in advance, death becomes meaningless, making life the same. Do you see now? Do you see that Stanley was already dead from the moment he hit start?
Achso, da sind ein paar Sachen dabei, die man schlecht lesen kann. This blueprint shows the office from the beginning of the game, the path of from Stanley's office to the two doors was the first part of the game that was built. Sections have been added and altered throughout development, though the core layout remains almost identical. Okay. Ist hier irgendwas außer nur einfach... Okay, ja, paintings. The pacing of this opening section was important to get right. This corridor has been moved and altered to make sure the player reaches the two doors in a good time. The set of the two open doors was the very first concrete piece of the Stanley Parable's design. Once this room was created, the rest of the game emerged as an extension of it, an exploration of the contradiction this room posed. US or the UK? Button. A selection of sounds used throughout the game when buttons are pressed. Each sound is a mix of keyboard strokes and a synthesized tone. Yep. Office Compupas. Einfache Credits. Alright. Ich weiß nicht, wie das aufgebaut ist. Also gehen wir erstmal einmal hier unten uns alles umgucken. Ja, dann geht's auch später hoch. The boss's office, hey, hey. Screens of development, yup. Office clock, nur nicht am Tiki-Tacken. I'm just gonna make this easy on you. Hey, kinda creepy. An early version of the underground portion. Narration outtakes. Kevin Bright. Yeah.
Shoot. Well, try the other one then.
The voice of the narrator recorded dialogue for the entire game throughout three separate times with 2 years development. These are clips from early takes.
Let's see. Stanley walked through the green door.
Angry.
This elevator for sure would get him right back on track to where he was supposed to be in the story. Now look closely, Stanley. See how it's impossible for the player to do anything in this room? Perfect example of poor level design. Textbook mistake. Stanley, it's the kind of thing you pick up on.
Okay. Freedom ending. This was the very first iteration. Countdown disc. Audio version, okay, yeah. Ja, das sieht auch early aus. Nochmal Freedom Ending in Beta. Monitor Room Elevator. For a time, the elevator in the monitor room could go up and down, with freedom above and countdown below. We abandoned this when player found it too difficult to remember what was up and what was down, and placed the two endings together instead. Countdown Room. Okay, da geht's dann wieder schon zurück. Jo, was war das für ein Gekrabbelgeräusch? Das haben wir das so gesehen erreicht? Game Design Mockup. Okay, the level designer sends the writer as a kind of audience piece. Strength of this level got William hired to design the full game. So much of the environment has changed. Ja. Ja, irgendein Kabelgeräusch. Then his office from left to right, the evolution of the office over time. The first was created in November 2011, 2012 March, and the third in February 2013. Okay. Finding Cabinets links rechts. Größerer Tisch. Das ist das, was mit dem Spiel antrifft. Alles klar. So, dann gucken wir mal ganz kurz nochmal hier. Narrator emails. After the second trailer we sent out, we asked people to email the narrator for questions, where we had initially planned to use these further promotional materials. We never found the perfect use for them. Here are a section of those. How do you stay in shape? Yeah, okay. Nope. Are you gay? Okay, aber halt scheinbar keine Antworten oder ähnliches. Money, money, money. Fun. Ich habe das Gefühl, da fehlt uns noch so einiges. Ich denke, das wird dann auch hier so gleich dieser Punkt. Der Early Development would be designed and ending with Stanley would end up on a battlefield fighting aliens. The action game would become sentient and would wage war against the narrator. We realized shortly after starting to build it that it was far too jokey and on the nose for the tone of the game. But some people interpreted it as making fun of people who dislike, who likes shooter, which was not our intention. Okay. Ich will noch einmal, genau, das ist jetzt hier. Also wir sind links, rechts hochgelatscht. The launch, early version. Ja, das finale Produkt sieht besser aus. Apartment timer. The previous version of the choice leading to the apartment ending. The timer would give you 15 seconds to pick up the phone. Not picking up the phone would lead to a different ending. Cargo lift. Second version was functional the same as what's in the final game, but we wanted it to look more like a place where cargo was actually stored. Ja, das sieht halt sehr, vielleicht Portal vom Aussehen, aber vom Design auch sehr Half-Life-y. The cargo lift was always intended to offer the choice of staying or jumping on a different path. However, after the, oder this early version, we decided we also wanted the option to play a falling to their death. Ja, das haben wir also alles gemacht. Das wird immer komplexer hier. Meeting Room. Okay. Mal einen Screenshot hiervon machen. So, genau. First Choice ist wirklich diese beiden Türen. Obey, Disobey. Okay, ist natürlich interessant zu sehen. Option 1. Always... Nee, the doorway to maintenance in the launch. Okay. Disobey, launch. Und genau, würden nach oben oder nach maintenance gehen können. Option... two options. Disobey ist gleich. The other entrance would be hidden depending on how you entered. Okay, 3, one option. Und the way to maintenance in the launch and the original back to the track. Too confusing ending, ja. Yeah. Vent, how about this? Okay, ja. Yeah. The flow of the hallway following the first two doors was important to get right, since players will replay them so many times. We discussed a number of designs, but ultimately it was the simplest version. Sending model. Sending went through many iterations. This room represents the fourth version of the ending, and we thought it was complete, but decided to abandon and change it shortly before launch. Sending levers. These levers were originally a part of the end. Sending. The player would pull a lever, and the narrator would describe what color they had pulled. Was mal getestet. Sending, the screenshot depicts an early version of the known ending as Sending, which was eventually cut and merged with another part. Ja, ja, auch hier wieder sehr stark Portal. This game is no pause. Das passiert auch, wenn man hier wirklich das Spiel so pausiert. Escape Menu. For a long time we had an ending that only ended when the player restarted from the escape menu. Unfortunately, very few people or players realized this was what they were supposed to do, which was frustrating for players. Ja, ist gut. Gut zu hören, dass sowas existierte, aber auch gut, dass sie es halt da entfernt hatten. So, da waren wir. Jetzt will ich nochmal hier gucken. Okay, also man merkt schon so ein bisschen, jetzt haben wir so ein... den Erklärungsraum gefunden. Und dementsprechend, das ist so grob das, was das, vermute ich auch damals ich, vom Basisspiel kennenlernen durfte. Was also bedeutet, hier werde ich dann mit dem nächsten Mal, weil ich denke, wir kommen jetzt hier gleich zum Ende, vermute ich mich mal vorbereiten, aber mal gucken, was es so gibt. Dann können wir vielleicht mal so eine Art Checkliste abarbeiten, was wir gemacht haben und was theoretisch fehlt, ohne direkt gleich zu gucken, was es vielleicht ist. Vielleicht reicht ja schon so der erste Schritt von, ich weiß, was die Beschreibung ist, weil ich meine, es gibt bestimmt, ich meine, ich gehe davon aus, dass es Steam Guides gibt, die halt alle Endings auflisten. Aber halt die Idee von, dass man halt einfach mal guckt, was haben wir, was fehlt und vielleicht kann man anhand der Beschreibung schon so ein bisschen erahnen, was man machen muss. Und logischerweise, ich gucke vorher die Namen mir wenigstens an, versuche mir da so Gedanken zu machen und wenn ich da schon nicht drauf komme, dann mache ich logischerweise gleich den nächsten Schritt hinterher. So, we ran four major teaser trailers over the course of the game's development, each meant to convey something about the spirit of the game. This is the first one released in May 12. It features a series of broken rooms and the voice of the narrator informing viewers that he is repairing a new version. Okay, da ich das jetzt natürlich kein Sound gespielt wird, ist es so ein bisschen witzlos und ich bin auch mal so frei und werde jetzt hier nicht vier Trailers absitzen. Sondern wir gehen jetzt hier rüber. Ansonsten sollte klar sein, ich will natürlich erstmal hier das Bar. Achso, das ist da hinten. Das Basisspiel abarbeiten, bevor wir dann wirklich den New Content weitermachen.
Oh, look at these two. How they wish to destroy one another. How they wish to control one another. How they both wish to be free. Can you see? Can you see how much they need one another? No, perhaps not. Sometimes these things cannot be seen. But listen to me. You can still save those two. You can stop the program before they both fail. Push escape and press quit. There's no other way to beat this game. As long as you move forward, you'll be walking someone else's path. Stop now and it'll be your only true choice. Whatever you do, choose it. Don't let time choose for you. Don't let time...